Lance Walter here, Chief Marketing Officer at Neo4j. Company is growing at a pretty healthy pace. We're just over 350 employees. Our focus is on enterprise customers. We define enterprise as above $1 billion a year in revenue. There's definitely a market here. There is a space, and we're happy about the fact that while we have a large footprint in it, it is much larger than we are and growing on a pretty regular basis. Neo4j was built originally, and we continue to optimize it and build the tooling around it to best understand connections inside data, to really to make relationships a first-class citizen and try to understand the full richness and context that lives inside the data. These are kind of what we think of as the golden six use cases. It's not to say that this is all anybody does with a graph database, but from a commercial perspective, from an enterprise customer perspective, it's certainly more than half of our use cases that fall into some flavor of one of these six. Our competition is always whatever they have. And if whatever they have is Cassandra or Mongo or Oracle or MySQL, that ends up being competition. But the vast majority of our deployments are incremental new use cases, greenfield.
I'm Philip Rathley. A lot of the value that companies are seeking today has to do with, from a data perspective, with understanding and getting their heads around dynamic real-world systems. And mastering dynamic real-world systems brings in a lot of complex technology challenges that are quite different, that involve random I/O and lots of hops and dense networks and different kinds of approaches, leaning very much more into the side of what relational databases allow you to do with joins. But also, these systems are harder to put into a box. It's harder to define upfront what the model should look like. You also tend to have a lot of outliers. So how do you fit a lot of outliers into predefined structures that are tabular? And then the technology constraints have changed a lot as well. Now I have quite abundant RAM. And then you also have storage devices that are not only large, but much more capable of handling lots of random hops. So Neo4j's structure was kind of built to solve the problem at the top left, with subject to the newer constraints. So this technology probably wouldn't have worked very well if you were to rewind even 10 years in the enterprise, where everyone was still running on spinning disks and didn't have a lot of RAM. There's a lot of data economy that also comes from being able to store your relationships as direct objects in the database rather than have large join tables, which then you index multiple ways, and there ends up being a lot of space efficiency. The database is our core technology, but because it's a relatively new thing still in the market, we've got a number of technologies surrounding the database to make it easier to use and develop with. We have a developer tool, we have a visualization tool, which Anurag will demo and show you shortly, and more.
I handle the graph analytics and AI programs, so graph data science, analytics, machine learning, AI, kind of anything in that bucket. So one of the things I think that we're well known for is handling very large transactional workloads. And so we too, if you book a hotel at Marriott or a Marriott property, you're actually using a Neo4j on the back end for the pricing. And there's 300 million pricing operations per day with Marriott. And being able to increase the amount of transactions they were able to do 10x in half of the amount of hardware compared to what they were doing previously. And what I like about this is it shows the uniqueness of Neo4j to kind of compact down what's required. So same amount of data, but how you store it and how you process it matters. And so it's an interesting idea to think of like scale inwards, scale in compactness, not just size.
Hi everyone, my name is Anurag Tandon. I have responsibility over Neo4j visualization, and I'm going to talk a bit about, in this section, I'm going to talk about Neo4j Bloom, our visualization product, providing graph visualization capability that differentiates what we do best and how we add value to our customers and their use cases is what we're aiming for. Essentially, what we have built is a very exploratory, ad hoc, you know, visualization product that allows you to see what your Neo4j graph has in it at a very intimate level. It's really about how, as an analyst, I can go in and search for the things, the patterns that I'm looking for in the graph, and let the graph tell me what it contains. We wanted to make the graph very approachable. And now this is a set of account holders, so you could think of them as essentially rows in a table. In this case, you're getting nodes from the graph. And if I want to see them in more detail, I can just keep going in, or I jump to this node and then I find this node here on the screen, get rid of this guy. Let's say, all right, for this particular node, I'm just interested in this one. I can dismiss everything else. I can start expanding from here and seeing what the detail is around this particular person. And then if I had more detail, then I could see, you know, more ways of expanding. And let's see if I can have that here. Yep, I can expand from here to the bank that the bank account belongs to. And and from there, I can expand to all of the other bank accounts that are there for that particular bank. And I can kind of continue to navigate this graph in this particular way.
Graph algorithms really highlight the structure when structure is just simply patterns, really. And when we can visualize those, I think they lead to a lot of intuitive understanding and follow-up from the data scientists.